better known as Johnny Ventura, nicknamed El Cabello Mayor, was a Dominican singer and band leader of merengue and salsa. He also served as a vice mayor of Santo Domingo from 1994 to 1998 and as mayor of Santo Domingo from 1998 to 2002. Family: spouse Nelly Josephine. He married to his wife in 1970. His wife is an American lady who is perceived as a famous VIP life partner. He had two sons. Son named Jandy Ventura. His son Jandy is an actor. He had five daughters. He had seven children in his life. Son named Juan Jose Ventura. Married Nelly, with whom he had three children. Estimated net worth of $6 million. He was born on 8 March 1940. He was born in La Vega, Dominican Republic. Year of active 1956 to 2021. Began his career as a singer when he presented himself with some friends in a program of devotees which was broadcasted by La Voz della Alegria weekly. The young Ventura, only 16 years of age, obtained first place of the participant. Little later, he started appearing in the program of devotees, which were sponsored by La Voz Dominicana. When Ventura Soriano appeared for the first time in the TV show La TV, Busca Una Estrella, that was broadcasted Friday night at 7, they rang the bell. In 1998, he was elected mayor of Santo Domingo, the capital of Dominican Republic. In 1959, he decided to take the name Johnny Ventura. Started his career as a singer in several bands and presented himself at the dances in La Feria. He worked with the orchestra of the Rondo, Ottawa, and in 1961 with the band of Dominican percussionist Donald Wild. In 1962, he sang with the combo Caribe of Luis Perez, with whom he recorded Cuidado con el Cubero, of which he was the author, and La Agradera of the Luis Perez. He recorded his first LP consisting of 12 songs. His instruments, vocals, in 1964, created his own orchestra, the Combo Show, which is known as an important part of the history of the popular Dominican music. In 1965, with his orchestra, recorded for the phonogram, on 28 March 2020, he announced that he had tested positive for COVID-19 during the COVID-19 pandemic and was hospitalized. On 13 April 2020, he announced he had recovered and had tested negative for the coronavirus. He died from a heart attack on July 28, 2021, at age of 81.